North Carolina, where they take barbecue very seriously, especially here in Lexington, which is considered the barbecue capital of the state. And the one place on everybody's radar here is called the Barbecue Center. It's a small restaurant, but it manages to sell 170,000 pounds of barbecue a year. It's a restaurant that's equally famous for the food as well as the family who serves it.
The restaurant started in 55. My father bought it in 1969. He passed away in 2013, and then my brother and I took it over, and we've been running ever since.
How many pounds of meat do you sell a year?
Around 170,000 pounds.
170,000 pounds of meat. And you also sell a lot of ice cream.
We have a huge banana split that weighs about 3 to 3.5 pounds. We were originally called a dairy center, serving ice cream only, and then in the late 50s, we added barbecue pits to supplement the income for the winter.
So, Willie, you are a regular customer. What is your favorite thing about this place?
It's a tradition. Barbecue, especially when the family's been running a business for as many years as they have, and it's passed down from generation to generation. But barbecue in this part of the country is a tradition. It's been done the same way for a long time. Every family in the restaurants and the businesses here are part of the community. And the Conrads have been just solid in the community and in the barbecue tradition.
Now, one of the neat things about this restaurant is it's one of the oldest restaurants that still cooks on pits. What does that mean?
We cook over hickory coals.
Okay, and can we go see it?
Absolutely, let's go look at it.
Let's do it. These are the famous pits. Tell me about the cooking process.
We take hickory slabs, we put them in our firebox, burn those down to coals, we shovel coals under the shoulders right here. It's very labor intensive, but it has a smoke flavor, which you can't get out of electric or gas stove.
So it's all about the end result, which makes a whole lot of sense.
It's all about the flavor.
So I'm all suited up, ready to get to work. What do we have here?
We have a shoulder that's been broken down into chunks. It's been deboned and fat, most of the fat taken out.
Uh-huh.
Now you're gonna take two cleavers. Very labor intensive, just like the cooking of it.
Uh-huh.
You ready?
Is that good?
That's good. It looks good.
Do I have a job?
You have a job.
All right, that's good. I start tomorrow. What do you think this restaurant means to the community?
It's a nice gathering place that they can come get good food and see a friendly face. It also brings people as a destination to help out with the community and the economy.
It's kind of a team effort to keep this restaurant going. Your mom, your brother, and you have some kids that are working here as well.
Yes, my mother's here every day for 8 hours. She's the matriarch of the family. And then we've got my stepdaughter, my niece, and my nephew that work here also. So we have 3 generations working here right now.
And I know your dad was the face of this restaurant for so long. And when he passed away, you described him as the best friend, best boss, and best father a man could ask for. So it sounds like you guys had a really good relationship.
We did. We worked every day together for over 20 years. And he was a very much a people person.
Side by side, huh?
Yes. We sat there in the booth and talked every day.
Aww.